my channel. We're gonna get straight into a 20-minute total body sculpt workout. Now this workout is a beautiful blend of yoga, Pilates, strength, and even a little bit of boxing. Now I have with me 3-pound weights. That is optional, grab whatever is available to you. You can also do all of this body weight and still get an amazing workout. I also have a mat. You might want a soft surface because we will be on our knees. Now the work is going to be 15 seconds on with each move and then 15 seconds rest, and that will give you enough time to transition through the moves. Now we're going to just start by dropping into our bodies and taking some centering breaths and some side openers. So join me now by just placing those fingertips by your sides and really root them and ground them into the earth as you open up that chest. Close your eyes. Take that first inhale. Really fill up the lungs. Pause at the top. Exhale, release. One more just like that, even bigger. Inhale. Hold. And exhale, let it all go. Open those eyes. Reach those hands up to the ceiling. As you exhale, place that left palm to the mat as you get a nice side body stretch. And then transition to the other side, right palm down. One more each side. Beautiful, all right. Ready, let's get into this work. Meet me in a quadruped position. All right, so in that quadruped position, we're gonna start in 5 seconds. Extend that right leg long, point the toe. Ready, let's go. Lift that right leg, tuck the toes, then bring that left knee to nose, and repeat. Lift, and then tuck that left knee in. Really root down through the ground, press through the fingertips, keep those fingertips nice and wide, energy through the hands as you squeeze that butt as you kick back, and then imagine that knee hits into that nose, even if it doesn't, that's alright. You want to really crunch in. This is a nice total body move, especially to get warmed up. And recover. All right, you can sit back into child's pose. Take whatever 15 seconds you need. And we're gonna move into that other side. All right, ready? In that quadruped position, extend that left leg long. Off you go, kick back. And then knee to nose, bring that right knee off the mat. Keep that breathing. So those same good breaths that we started with, use that in your workouts. Beautiful. Halfway. Really squeeze that left glute on that kickback. Kiss that knee to nose. Last one, and recover. All right, next move, downward dog tie plank. So you're gonna be in a downward dog, and you're gonna ripple through the spine and shift into a high plank. Ready? Let's go, downward dog. Press back, bring those heels to the mat, then tippy toes, ripple through the spine, high plank. Push back. This one feels so good in the body. So really tuck that chin to chest, abs nice and strong. And you wanna check that form in that high plank. Make sure those shoulders are over wrist, that tailbone is tucked under. Relax the face, deep breaths. Recovery coming up. And recover. All right, next move. We're gonna be on the right leg. So I'm gonna flip over this way. Donkey kick. So you come down to your elbows, kick up
with that right foot and bring that knee to the mat. Off you go, donkey kick. Now I'm gonna really get into the right glute for the next few moves. So isolating that right side. Point the toe, really squeeze as you lift, then kiss that knee to the mat. Keep those elbows tucked in, that core is nice and tight, neutral spine. Now, if you want my advanced for your recovery, hold that donkey kick and just give me a little pulses. If you want to take your recovery, take your recovery. Yeah? You want to. All right, we're going to be on that left elbow. Diamond, shape that right knee. Let's go, a little lift. So that 15 seconds rest is optional. You can take it or just hold an ice and hold or take little pulses in your movement. Good, little lifts. Really open up that hip, that right hip. Breathe. Relax the face. Soften into it. Recovery coming up. Now you can hold it here. Next move, you're gonna come over, curtsy, and then kick out to the side. Are you ready? Maybe tap out that right glute. Get ready. And let's go, curtsy and kick. So this one's great for the glute, but also, you're gonna feel that in your core. And keep pressing down energy through the mat. That upper body is supporting you. Inhale, exhale. Slow through the movement, slow in strength. And recover. If you want to hold it, you can give me pulses, hold it, otherwise, recover. Next move. We're on our left side. Bring those knees out in front of you. We're going to do a clam opener. Ready? Let's go. Toes off the mat. Open that right knee. Extend it. Then bring it back down. Open, extend. Bring it down to that diamond. And then close the knees. You got it. Breathe. This is your last move, isolating that right side. And then we're going to be standing up with our weights. You can always take that advanced option, bring that right hand off the mat. Ooh, that right glute's on fire. And recover. All right, so grab your weights if you have them. Bring them at your chest. Right leg is forward. Okay, I lied. We're still isolating the right side. But now it's a bit more total body. Ready? Let's go. Lunging. Down and up. Static lunge on the right. Ooh, catch that balance. Driving that right heel. So we're still on that right side doing some unilateral work, but now I'm going to fire up the whole body. Legs, arms, abs. Keep that chest nice and tall. Stabilize through the core. Almost there. And recover. You're gonna come forward, weight in that right side. Extend the arms. As you bring that left foot in, tap, bicep curl, and out. Are you ready? Shake it up. left knee in. You curl the arms in that bicep curl. Still sink into that right side, that right glute. You should feel it from all that work on the mat. Good, keep it up. Sink down a little lower into that right leg. Sorry, not sorry. Shake it out. Dance it out. All right, we're still on the right side. Lunge pulses with your hands overhead. So, right foot forward. Ready, let's go. Pulse. Little pulses. Keep that chest up tall. Strong arms overhead. Drive through that right heel for me. Peel that belly button into the spine. I know. Come on, almost there. Can you sit an inch lower for me? Drop that back knee down a little. Down an inch, up an inch. Come on. Come on. Lean into the shakes. Recover. Ooh, shaking is good. That's a sign of getting stronger. All right, hands overhead. High knees as you bring those hands down. Ready, deep breaths. Let's go. High knees. As you bring that knee up, you want to bring those elbows in, tuck them into the body, and press as you press that foot back to the mat. Getting that heart rate up with this one. Knees right up. Stay strong. Stay with me. Recover. You earned this recovery. All right, weights down. Now we go to the left side. So remember, we started with those donkey kicks on the right. Come down to your elbows. Let's go. Donkey kick on the left. Ooh, that heart should be pounding. That is good. That is beautiful. That's where I want you. So now we're going to slow things down, go back to sculpting, and be really mindful of our movements here. Squeeze that left glute. Core is strong. Peel that belly button into the spine. Tuck those elbows in. Stay with me. You got this. Once again, if you don't want that rest, hold, you can pulse. Next move. Open up on that right elbow. Diamond shake the left knee. Ready? Little pulses down and up. In 3, 2, 1, let's go. Little lifts. Really think about bringing those heels to the ceiling. So open up through that hip. Little lifts and drops. So it's a small movement, but oh boy, it's effective. Come on. You might also feel that stabilizing side, that right side that we just worked. So it's still working now. Even stabilizing, recover. All right, next move, that curtsy and kick on the left. Take a breath. Inhale, exhale, let's go. Curtsy and kick.
Really cross that left knee behind the right. Kick out to the side. Point the toe. Energy through those legs. Good. Almost there. Stay strong. Breathe into it. Recover. Now on that left side, oh no, right side. Lay down on your right side. Work in that left. Knees out in front of you, 90 degrees, toes off. Clam openers, let's go. Open, extend, and then back down. Now, if you took that advanced option before, lift that left hand off for a bit of an extra bone here. Good, come on. So by taking that hand off, I actually enjoy that. I feel that more in my abs as well. Extra ab burn with that glute. Squeeze and lift. Last one. So good. All right. Standing tall. Grab your weights if you have them. Left foot forward. Starting with those lunges, hug those weights in. Down and up. Stabilize. So goblet lunge here. Drop that back knee down. Drive through that left heel. Chest tall, come on. It's okay if you have one side better than the other. I felt my right a little more wobbly today. Some days that's just how it is. Accept that we embrace and love. Keep working. Knee behind the toe. And recover. So next move, if you remember, we're going to sink into that left side. But instead of curling, we're going to do a kickback. As leg goes back, extend the weights back. Ready, hug the weights in, elbows in tight. Extend and in. Stay into that left knee. Tap that right foot out. Tricep kick back. You hit it from the front, down from the back. Squeeze those triceps. Really kick behind you. That back wall. Can you sit an inch lower into that left side? You got it. Almost set. Recover. Shake it out. Dance it out. Hands overhead. Lunge pulses. Ready, left foot forward still, little pulses, let's go. Energy through your hands, soft elbows, core strong, feel that belly button into the spine. Hey, how are we going? Can you sit an inch lower? Oh boy, I'm feeling it. I'm right here with you. Come on, don't give up now. Recover, shake it out. Back to those high knees now. So weights up, knees to chest. Ready? On the beat. Let's go. wide squat. Squat down, twist and punch. We're gonna do both sides. Ready? Alternating. Let's go. Down and punch. See, I told you there was a little bit of boxing. Booty down, punch the weight as you twist that same leg as arm. Power through that hip and the punch. Come on, last move. Give it your all, right here. Total body burn. Almost there. Sit lower in that squat. Power in the punch and recover. Whew. Weights down. Feel that heart. Feel that chest. Feel that heartbeat. Give gratitude to that. Because hey, it's a new day. We're alive, our heart's beating. And we get to move our bodies. Yeah? We don't have to, we get to. That mindset helps me every day showing up. Sit wherever is comfortable. Roll those shoulders back and down. Take those arms up, inhale. Exhale, drop to the left, just how we started. Side body stretch. Up and over. Switch sides. One more. Each side. Inhale. Exhale as you come over and sink into that stretch. Beautiful. Alright, let's push back into a downward dog. Lift that right leg up. Bring that knee to nose and come into your pigeon stretch. Now, square off those hips. If this feels good here, stay there. Otherwise, join me in a sleeping pigeon and just breathe. Melt into the mat. One more breath. And then coming up, pedal out. And let's move into that left side or left leg off the mat. Three-legged dog, knee to nose. Into your pigeon on the left, square off the hips. Either stay here or come all the way down into that full sleepy pigeon. Those legs back in front of you. Sit down wherever is comfortable. Roll those shoulders back and down. Let's sit down, slow down. Inhale, bring those hands up. As you exhale, bring them down to heart center. Thank you for showing up to this class. It means the world. This is a new platform for me, so I really appreciate you here. So please like, subscribe, let's connect. My name is Courtney Watts, and I hope to see you next time. Thank you. Have a beautiful day.